due to pirate content. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hi, does this bus go to Pico in Vermont?
Nope.
I'm sorry to bother you, but do you happen to know if I got off at the next stop, could I take a bus back up to Santa Monica? All right. Well, that's just great.
Great, like the sea.
First time on a bus?
Yeah. I thought I could go to Pico in Vermont and then, like, walk to work, but, you know, my Geo wouldn't start this morning. And usually it's just...
If you get off at the next stop, you can take the number 7 bus to Pico in Vermont.
Oh, thanks. I'm Dan.
Christy.
All right, cool. Christy.
That's you.
Oh, that's me. All right.
Kill a robot. The robot and its keeper live! Welcome, lads, to the Culver City Revenge.
I'm sorry. Maybe it's just because I haven't ridden the bus before, but what exactly are you?
What are we, you ask? Bradley!
Assistant to the regional director of sales.
Perfect! Our sales be full of holes. Bring him some catgut and bone needle.
I think you're misunderstanding me. It's not...
Dan, we be pirates. Aye?
Yeah.
And what do pirates do, Dan?
I don't know.
We search for treasure, lad.
Yeah, okay, I get it now. Okay, you're bus pirates and you're searching for buried treasure.
Who said anything about it being buried? You know an awful lot for a director of sales!
No, I'm sorry, I was just assuming.
never assumed, Dan. When you assume, you make an ass out of Yumi. That's Yumi.
Well, thank you very much for the lift. But we're gonna get off right here. This is our stop.
Rosa Parks.
What the hell is going on?
It's Redbeard and his band of villains. Only he would be spineless enough for an ambush.
This makes absolutely no sense.
I, robot, your cold steel robot heart knows nothing of honor. But it is customary to declare one's intentions before engaging in battle. Raise the Jolly Roger! Prepare for battle.
Captain, at the next stop! It'd be Redbeard and a detail of his men!
Don't stop. Just don't stop.
Aye, but we must stand. It's called a bus stop, not a bus go!
That's not getting off.
Hold on a second. You can't get off right here. It's the middle of a pirate battle.
I know, Dan. That's the problem. I'm supposed to be at work right now, but thanks to you, we're in the middle of a pirate battle. And I'm a robot.
Robot thing, it was just the first thing that came to mind. But you know, by the way, I did kind of save your life today.
Okay, you know what? You're right. Thanks for saving my life. Hey, David, yeah, it's me. Is there any way you can pick me up?
Your men are beaten.
And let you find the treasure?
Never! Curses. Getting off. Well, Bonaire, it looks as though I've taken yet another ship from you.
Even with a day's head start, you'll never get to the treasure before me.
Let's see you find anything without your robot.
Hell happened.
Aye, lad. In all his foulness, Redbeard has stolen our robot.
How could you just stand there while those nuts kidnapped her?
Don't worry, lad. Another ship will come. And perhaps another robot he'll find.
Ah! Oh, God, this is insane! I can't even believe I'm having this conversation. What grown man thinks he's a pirate? You know what? You guys can just sit here and wait for your next vessel to come along. But I'm not a part of this fantasy world, okay? Some of us have jobs and lives and bills to pay. These are not ships. They're buses. That guy is not a scurvy dog. He's a psychopath, and you are not pirates.
I know, Dan. I was like you once. We all were. Peter here did construction. Worked overtime to build his wife that pool she always wanted. Until she left him for the pool boy. Chris! Chris was a telemarketer who was fired for refusing to make phone calls at dinner time. Bradley was heir to the Colgate fortune.
I just got sick of the grind.
I worked at an engineering company in Pasadena.
For 10 years. 10 years! Of nights and weekends. And when the position above me opened up, do you know who got the job? The CEO's son. Right out of community college. that night. Riding the bus home from work, I decided I'd had enough. I stopped at the nearest costume shop and left my old life behind. Never to look back again.
What about him?
Oh, he has always been like that.
Well, what are we gonna do now? I mean, you know, I'm probably fired already, and it's my fault that Christy got kidnapped.
Yeah. Well, you could go back to your old life. Or another bus be coming every 15 to 20 minutes. Half an hour after 7 with a red line between midnight and 5. What do you say, lad? Where the wind blows?
I say I.
Thanks. Captain, the 88! She approaches from the north!
Well then come on. You know what? We got a bus to catch and a robot to save!
I'm not getting on one more bus until you tell me what the plan is, huh? When are we gonna catch up with Redbeard?
Oh, you seem awfully attached to that robot boy.
What? No, I'm just... Quit changing the subject.
Careful, my boy. A full heart entrusted to a robot's care is no safer than a mermaid's song cast beyond the perilous straits.
You don't even know where they are.
No. You must ask the Black Oracle.
Black like the sea.
The Black Oracle! Black Oracle.
The Black Oracle? Coffee run!
Finally! Back there! You go for it, I've got a thing!
Wallet.
What?
You smell goat milk?
Are you the the Oracle?
That's right. They call me Lewis.
Hey, wait a minute. That's ridiculous.
You still looking for that hot robot? If you want to find her, you gotta find the treasure of the nights. It's what all bus pirates seek. The treasure of the nights.
in Satan's service.
It all started a long time ago, in 1976. Kiss was on tour promoting Destroyer, and they took a chest of gold doubloons with them wherever they went. But the treasure was not safe. The first bus pirate, the one all other bus pirates aspired to be like, was tracking them across the interstate. One night, when Kiss was playing charades, he stormed the bus and took their treasure. But when he was forced to find an alternate means of transportation, he boarded the bus and escaped.
Then what?
Then they caught him at the next stop, but the treasure was never found.
Oh. But what does this have to do with Christy?
The robot prophecy.
Wait, robot prophecy?
Yeah, the robot prophecy.
Why robot?
Robots love Kiss. The prophecy states, when children cheer and old men leer, to my watchful eye you shall appear. When the sky is dark and filled with mist, your compass be your robot's kiss.
Okay. And if Christy's not actually a robot?
If Redbeard doesn't find his booty,
then he's gonna want his booty. Woohoo! Woo! Robot booty!
Yeah. Ah! Do you like girl books? Ah!
No.
Do you want this tampon?
That's a pen.
Eat this turnip!
Eat it!
No.
What do you see? Yeah.
Huh? A robot.
Does he think Addison and McSteamy just have to get together?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
The sexual tension.
She be unprivate friends now.
Fine, enough! Toss me that turnip.
Oh.
Funny thing, robot.
You sure? Throw like a girl!
Get a coffee drink.
I'm talking to the Black Oracle.
Oh, you mean Lewis the Oracle? Whose color matters not to us?
I hate racism.
Lewis is black? Yeah, he said something about a treasure that belonged to Kiss and that Christy is part of some sort of robot prophecy. And, you know, the man lives in a freaking Skid Row Yoda cave in the back of a city bus. I think he might be a little bit insane.
Who's Christy? Redbeard! On air!
Christy! That Christy!
Oh, Christy!
You gotta stop this bus. Call the police. Something.
Mm-mm. Kidnapped!
She's no!
Mind the other line, Dan, and don't worry. I have a plan! We pry open the aft doors of the bus, leap to the Culver Revenge, and win her back! Come on!
She's not a robot.
Listen, honey, I'm not supposed to tell nobody this, but I'm on my break for the next 10 minutes. My break for the next 10 minutes.
No! Dad, wait!
I believe you have my bus.
bone air. We have to work on that. Put your back into it, lad. Don't worry, Chisty.
Christy.
Soon you'll be my pirate bride.
Let her go.
No, Dad. This is between men and their swords.
I have a sword.
Stand in my way. Sure as traffic fines be doubled in construction zones, you will be my pirate bride.
Enough already! I have been kidnapped, interrogated, intimidated, and dragged around for the last time. I am not your pirate bride! You are not cool, not sexy, not hardcore. You're gross! Misogynistic, immature, and a horrible rapper!
Ouch, Chisty.
For the last time!
Overpass!
Christy? Wait. Holy.
What is it?
It's a prophecy. It's true.
What are you talking about, Dan?
That where children cheer and old men leer, to my watchful eye it shall appear when skies are dark and filled with mist. Compass be your robot's kiss.
No!
Dan, 'twas only a metaphor. Don't you see? There was never a real treasure.
No, that doesn't make any sense, though. What about there was a prophecy in the black...
The Oracle lives on a bus, Dan. Let's face it, he'd be a crazy homeless man. The real treasure lie inside you.
I mean...
Yes!
The real treasure being what you've learned about yourselves and all the friends you've made along the way.
Think of Yumi, his loyalty rivaled only by his strength. Think of Bradley, whose jovial nature made him the best friend a man could have. Think of that big, angry pirate, though silent in speech, spoke loudly enough through his actions. And think of Stumpy, always willing to lend a hand, even though he doesn't have him. We may go our separate ways today, but you'll always carry a little piece of this adventure with you. For I know I will.
I don't know, I thought after all this there'd be a real treasure.
Oh, well, there's always a real treasure. Sometimes you just can't see it. Ah! But the winds have changed. I must take my leave. Robot, director of sales, may the seas of your journey be calm and the winds full, but not the kind that japes you.
Okay, what you're saying is that the...
Yes, that's right, you've totally got it.
Will we ever see you again?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. I go where the wind blows. Riverside. Trim the sails! Raise the mizzen mast! Wipe off the seats! A new adventure begins!
So, now what?
I don't know, Dan. I mean, we were just in a pirate battle and... Well, I'm a robot.
Yeah. Want to split a cab?
Yeah.
You don't think they're taxi pirates, do you?
I don't know. I always took the bus.